In the last video, I talked about unary functions and function querying. In this video, we will look into all of this in practice. Let's just start by defining our sum function. So our sum function, I'm going to call it normal sum. It's going to receive two parameters, and it's going to return a plus b. Let's try this. One and two, for example, and if we save, we should see three on the right side. All right, let's define the queried version of this. What does it mean? It means that we want to define a function that receives one parameter and returns another function that receives another parameter, and so on until we have all the parameters and we can do the calculation. So our function is going to be, let's call it sum. It receives one parameter. It's going to return, we haven't seen all the parameters, so another function receives a second parameter. And now that we have all the parameters, we're going to return a plus b. Let's try this. Console log sum one. How should we do this? We call it with one, receives another function that expects a second parameter, and if we do this, three again. All right, let's make this more functional look. So let's start by defining the type. We want to define a sum function that receives one parameter, returns a function that receives a second parameter, and returns, at the end, returns the number. So const sum of type sum is receives a number, receives another parameter, and at the end does the calculation for us. If I save, same result. For the next step, let's try to define some helper functions. For example, let's define increment function. It's going to receive one number, and it's going to increment that number. How can we do this? Const increment of type increment. So we want to reuse our sum function, right? That's the whole point. Please pause the video and try it for yourself. All right. So how can we do this? We can actually call sum with 1, and it's going to return us a function that receives another number and adds a 1 to it. Exactly what we need, right? This style is called point-free style because we are not mentioning any parameters for increments here, right? Let's try this. Console log increment. Let's try this with value 6, for example. And if we save, we should see 7. Let's try another one. Let's try to define decrement, right? Again, pause the video, see how we can do this. All right, done. Let's look at this. We're going to receive a number, and we're going to receive another number with one value lower. So decrement of type decrement is going to, we need to call a sum with what value? You guessed it right, minus 1. If we try this again with value 6, decrements, what we should see is 5 as an output. Great. Let's clean this up a little bit. All right, the sum function here, the queried one, is kind of like we hardcode stuff. It wouldn't be great that we have a general query function that receives normal sum and returns us the queried version of it. Let's try it. Let's try to define a function called query2, meaning that it receives a function that receives two parameters. Receives a function that receives two parameters, receives a first parameter, then receives b, the second parameter, and it's going to call our f with a and b, right? Good. Let's define our caret function sum. Let's call it this one too. Let's call carry 2 on our normal sum. And we're expecting to see a caret function, right? So now if we try this, console log sum 2 with, let's say, 1 and 2. If we save, we see 3 again, right? Awesome. So now let's define the type for our caret function. The type would be, let's call this one carry 2. All right, what does it receive first? A function that receives two parameters. First number, the second one is a number, and it's going to return a number. Then it's going to return us a caret function that first receives the first parameter, returns another function that receives the second parameter, and then it's going to return a number. Let's add this to our carry function. If we save, it should be the same. Great. Our general carried function is really tied to numbers, right? So let's fix that, meaning that we want to define a carried function that receives a function that its first parameter is any type A, the second parameter it gets is any type B, and it returns any type Z. So it returns a carried function that receives one parameter A, then B, and Z. And thanks to a generic function, we can define type parameters A, B, and Z like this. If we save, same result. This is for carry 2, meaning like the functions that only receives two parameters. We can define carry 3, 4, until some number. All right. Thank you for watching this video, and I will see you in the next one.